I work for Seres Therapeutics. We are developing new type of drugs based on microbes found in the human body, in the human microbiome. Recently, we've presented results, exciting results in the area of inflammatory bowel disease, specifically ulcerative colitis, showing that the proper cocktail of these organisms can induce durable remissions in patients with active disease. And I'd like to tell you about that. SER-287 is a drug that is sourced from human donors. And we derive that drug by a process that isolates and purifies spores found naturally in the human gut. These spores are hardy and resistant, such that we can use processes that inactivate all the other living matter in the stool, and then using procedures for purification, end up with a pharmaceutically pure form of these organisms in a small number of oral capsules that are convenient for a patient to take. In a recently announced study with SER-287, we found that a daily administration of SER-287 led to complete remission in patients with active mild to moderate ulcerative colitis in 40% of patients. In the placebo group, we saw no remissions. These were all evaluated by endoscopy at baseline and 8 weeks after treatment. Importantly, we found that patients who responded to SER-287 treatment engrafted organisms from the drug product in a different way than patients who didn't respond. In other words, there was a clear signature of that treatment. In addition, we saw evidence for histologic healing, meaning when we took mucosal biopsies before and after the treatment, patients who remitted also showed evidence of positive changes in their histology, suggesting deep tissue healing with SER-287 administration. One of the things that this drug promises for patients is a non-immunosuppressive oral regimen that potentially can be very durable. In fact, when we looked at engraftment 4 weeks after the treatment had stopped, we found no difference in the engraftment of SER-287 organisms into the gut. And patients who remitted at 8 weeks, we followed for another half of a year, 26 weeks, and found that everyone who had gone into remission stayed in remission over that 26-week period. Now, this is a small study of 58 subjects, and so our next objective is to verify the findings and evaluate additional doses in a larger next study. We think this is an important new way of treating ulcerative colitis because existing drugs work downstream on either the trafficking of T cells into the gut or the immune effectors, particularly the production of cytokines that are occurring once inflammation has already started. We know and have known for many years, however, that the microbiome is a primary driver of inflammation in the gut. And so our ability to intercept inflammation at its point of origin by changing the microbiome promises to be a safe and potentially effective new way of treating ulcerative colitis. One of the things that we learned from this study, in addition, was the signature that we got from the microbiome treated patients who remitted. That treatment allows us to consider how we're going to design a next generation product, which we call SER-301, which is currently in development. And SER-301 will be based on the principle of isolating individual microbes, growing them up by anaerobic fermentation, and then mixing them back together into a cocktail that can be administered again orally to patients, and so entirely removed human donors from the equation. We think this is the future of the use of these live biotherapeutics, and we're excited to be part of this cutting-edge therapy.